Yes, sir. You ready, bro? You ready? All right, because if you haven't seen it yet, you gotta grab your popcorn and sit down for this one, because I'm about to show you one of the most busted things you're probably gonna see in this game. Now, there's a lot of busted things in this game, but either way, this is freaking nuts. So with that being said, what I really do, DC gang, welcome back to the channel, my boys, my gangsters. As always, I hope you guys are having a great day out there, gang. So with that being said, I'm about to show you about 2 to 3 different decks. I'm gonna show you this one, and if you're looking at it and there's certain cards in the extra deck that you think they should be there, I probably know about them, I just don't have them because they're URs. So I play the deck this way. So I'm also gonna show you about 2 reference deck lists for the Master Duel Meta website. So stay tuned for that. So with that being said, just a quick reminder, if you guys enjoy the content, please remember to leave a like, share, comment, and subscribe to the boy, because I would greatly appreciate it. So with that being said, we're gonna run it up straight to this one. It's a 50 card deck list, Genex. If it's not C, that's a bar. I just gotta write stupid names on my deck so I can remember them. So the whole thing about this deck is that you get this repair Genex controller onto the field, and after that's done, you basically get to special normal summon a gazillion times. So we're gonna run one Genex controller mainly because we're gonna search him out by using the effect of this monster right here, the Genex Undyne, and it's a level 3 tuner normal monster, which is insane, which is gonna help you go into some synchro plays, nothing else. You only need one, and you gotta remember that if you use this thing's effect and this thing is in the graveyard already, you can't use this thing's effect to send the water monster to the graveyard in order to activate its effect if you're gonna play the deck this way. Just remember that. Yeah, I made a mistake once or twice with this thing. This thing has to be in the deck for you to be able to activate its effect. So then we're gonna run 3 Genex Power Planner, because we're planning on taking these W's. So when this card is normal summon, you can add 1 level 3 Genex effect monster from your deck to your hand. Now basically, they all have almost, well, most of them have the effect that once they're normal summoned, you get to basically search out another Genex monster, and every time you search out a Genex monster and add it to the hand, this thing is gonna prompt itself to activate to basically normal summon another monster onto the field. So every time you add monsters to the hand by any means necessary, this thing will normal summon a monster, which is actually nuts. You're gonna see it in the replays. Then we're gonna run one Genex Recycled. It's a level 1 tuner. Based on how you do the combo, you can end up just, you know, normal summoning this to go into your synchro monster, and then you keep making plays from there. It's just a level 1 tuner that you're gonna search out at some point in time. Then we're gonna run 3 R Genex Crusher, because any one of these specific ones that we're playing 3 copies of, which is this one and the other ones that you're gonna see, they all are 1 card combo starters. You just need 1 copy of these, you start your combo. If you don't get hit with a problem, any hand trap, then you're gonna go crazy. So we're gonna run 3 copies of the R Genex Crusher. This one is gonna search you out a level 4 Genex monster. Then we're gonna run 3 Maxi for Maxi reasons, you know how that goes. Then we're gonna run 1 R Genex Touring, which is a level 2 tuner, so you could use this to go into your synchro place as well. You could normal summon and stuff like that. This one doesn't add cards to the hand, so you gotta be careful with that. The same thing with this one, it doesn't add cards to the hand, so once you normal summon these, you're basically done normal summoning, unless you can synchro summon into a monster that allows you to bounce cards back, or unless you did the combo with this card and you brought this back from the graveyard with another card, and then you continue extending from there, which you're gonna see in the replays. So we're gonna run 1 copy of it. Also, you could use this during the second turn after you went first, and if you never made your Genex monster, if you have an extra Genex monster that you have in the extra deck, you could activate this thing's effect, special summon it from the hand, and basically has the same effect as Hoppy Squadron. You can synchro summon into a Genex monster with it, so it's really cool. Then we're gonna run 1 copy of the Genex Undyne. Like I said, you only need 1 copy because you're gonna search it out, normal summon it, you're going to basically send this monster to the graveyard, and you're gonna search out your Genex controller or add it to the hand, which is gonna allow you to normal summon it if you have the space already on the field. Then we're gonna run 1 R Genex Magma. This is another 1 card starter. When this card is normal summon, you're gonna add a level 2 R Genex monster, which is they're all crazy. Then we're gonna run 1 Genex Ally Birdman, which is the level 3 tuner. This one allows you to add one of your monsters from the field to the hand, And then you get to Special Summoner, which is a level 3 tuner, which can allow you to extend into more plays as well, which is insane. And you can use all of these monsters' effect. They're not one per turn. They're none of them is once per turn, so they're all nuts. So we're going to run 3 copies of it. Unfortunately, it's not a starter. If you open up with this and none of your other, any one of these 3, then you're not going to have a great time because it's not a starter. You know what I'm saying? You can't search by normal summoning this, so that's one of the downsides to it. Then we're gonna run 3 Ash Blossom for Ash Blossom reasons. Then we're gonna go with the R Genex Turbo, which is a level 4 RX monster, which is also a one card starter. This one is gonna search you out your level 1, which most of the time will be the Genex Power Planner, or this one if you already have the Power Planner and you're doing your combo. Then we're gonna run 1 copy of the R Genex Undying. Like I said, it's a part of your combo with your Genex Undying, which you're gonna normal summon this, send this to the graveyard. And then at some point in time, you could activate this thing's effect, bring it back to the hand to extend your plays. Now, mind you, once you activate this thing's effect, you can't send cards to the graveyard. They'll be banished. So be careful with that, because if you have Horror Shenanigans and you haven't activated yet, but you want to activate it at the end turn when you made your board, you won't be able to after you activate this thing's effect. So be careful with that. Speaking about Horus, we are running a small Horus package, because if you use the Horus package, one of the things that you can do is go into a Hierarctic Sky Dragon Overlord, and it's gonna protect you from Valor, and it's gonna protect you from Infinite Impermanence. So we're gonna run 3 copies of the Amseti Glory of the Horus. We're gonna run 1 copy of the Happy. We're gonna run 1 Nibiru of the Primal Being. You know, for going second shenanigans is good, so we're gonna run 1 copy of it. We're gonna run 2 copy of Cerevis, the Asian, and the Ascended. Now, mind you, I would run 3 copies of this if I had 3. I only have 2, but you have so many one card starters in this deck that you legitimately wouldn't even mind running this thing at 3. Which is, you know, if you have 3 of them, I recommend you do so, because it protects you from Valor and Infinite Impermanence as well. Then we're gonna run 1 Harpies for the Duster for going second shenanigans, so we can break some boards. We're also gonna run the Lightning Storm. We're gonna run 1 Triple Tactic Talent because I'm talented. 3 Triple Tactic Thrust because, you know, we're playing the normal monster, so we could activate it, set down a trap if we're going first, or activate it and get our board breakers if we need to. Then we're gonna run 2 copies of the Wall of the Imperial Tomb, because a lot of time you might again want to open up with the Horus package shenanigans, so you're gonna play a little bit of more extended package of for the Horus shenanigans. So we're gonna run 3 King Sarcophagus. Again, if you don't have 3 because it's a UR, just run more copies of the Wall of the Imperial Tomb. Just run 3 if you have 2 of these, you'll be fine. If you have 1, then just run 1. Run whatever you have, because, you know, it could be a little expensive getting all of these URs right here. So then we're gonna run 2 copies of the Call by the Grave, because Call by the Grave is busted. Then we're gonna run the evenly matched at 1 again, so we can search or set up with a Triple Tactic Talent for going second. We're gonna go for 3 Infinite Impermanence, because it's one of the best hand traps in the game as of right now. Now let's get into the extra deck. For the extra deck, we're gonna run 1 Hero of the Arc Light. This thing is tough. It basically, it's an Omni Negate, and it's somewhat of a floodgate, because any card sent to the graveyard from the hand or deck is gonna get banished instead, which kills a lot of the good decks in this game. It kind of does, what do you call it? Yubel doesn't like this, and Tier Limits doesn't like this, Light Swarm doesn't like this. It's a few amount of decks in the game that do not like this card being on the field. Then we're gonna run 1 Dew Lorner, Tiger King of the Ice Barrier, which essentially, once you synchro summon into this thing, you could target as many cards on your field as you want and bounce them back to the hand, which is gonna allow you to extend your combo. You're probably gonna see that in the first replay. Then we're gonna run 1 Briarmak, the Magical Ice Dragon. This is another card that is gonna allow you to bounce a card back to the hand, so that way you could extend your combos, or you could use it during opponent's turn to bounce one of their cards back to the hand. So this thing is tough. One downside is that you're gonna have to discard a card to do so, which you don't mind, because with this deck you're gonna end up with about 7 cards in the hand after doing your combo anyways. So then we're gonna run 1 FA Dawn Dragster, which is a level 7 spell and trap negate, so we're gonna play it because we can make level 7 like it's nobody's business. Then we're gonna run 1 Cybers Quantum Dragon. Now mind you, I kind of rarely ever went into this thing. It's really cool, it's really good, but I prefer to go into some of the other level 7s that we have. The only other level 7 that we have, which is this one. So if you want to go into this one, it's okay. It protects you from, it has battle protection. So basically, when you control a Link monster, which you're always going to have this thing on the field, it says, Most of your opponent control cannot target most of your control for attack, except for this one. Also, your opponent cannot target most of your control with card effects, except for this one. Once per turn, at the start of the damage step, you discard battles on opponent monster. You can return that opponent monster to the hand. Also, this card can make a second attack in a row, which is a really cool card for going first, for better protection, going second, to kind of like break the board a little bit, right? Then we're gonna run one Draco Berserker of the Tenu for one of our level 8 synchros that we can run, especially going second. Then we're gonna run one Animacipator Recent Dragai, which is again great for spell and trap negation. Then we're gonna run one Vermilion Dragon Mech, and this thing right here, just some sauciness, you could switch it out. I rarely ever went into this as much, but you basically activate this effect, you're gonna pop itself, and then you're gonna basically add one of your tuners that's banished back to the hand, which could be this thing, which is gonna allow you to extend your combo even more depending on how you're doing the combo, right? Then we're gonna run one Balloon de la Flor because you can make level 10 synchros pretty kind of easily. Then we're gonna run one Arms of the Genex Return Zero, which is basically a bunch of negates. This thing can negate up to 6 times, up to 6 different attributes. Light, dark, earth, water, whatever you wanted, the avatar is dead, is gone. This thing destroys everything, which is really cool. Now, it's only for monsters. It doesn't have any protection against spells and traps, which is one of the downsides, but it is pretty cool. Then we're going to run one number 90 Galaxy Ice Phantom Lore, you know, for the Horus package to level 8. It protects you from Nibiru, because Nibiru will clap this deck as well. Then we're going to run Heraldic Sky Dragon Overlord. Again, your protection against Infinite Impermanence and Veiler. Then we're going to run 2 copies of the Repair Genex Controller, because, you know, just in case you went first, they actually managed to break your board a little bit. You're going to need the second copy. Hopefully, you're not playing against Castira and they already banished one copy, because then you're going to be sad. So that is the deck list that I'm playing. That is how I'm playing the deck. Now, let me show you about 2 reference deck lists real quick. Let's get into that. All right, familia. So here we are in the Master Duel Meta website, and this is Dusky deck, which is a 40-card deck list. If you want to run this deck nice and tight, very precise, I really like this one right here. This guy is playing the ultimate protection for this deck right here, which is a 40-card deck list. Again, we're running 3 copies of the Planner. We're going to run 2 copies of the Crusher, which I want to run all of these at 3, but it's a 40-card deck list, so you're fine running at 2. He's also going to run 2 Magmas. He's going to run 1 Touring. He's also going to run 3 Birdmen, 4 Turbos, 1 of the Undyne, which, where's the... Confusing to me, because he should be playing the other Undyne, but either way, he's going to run 3 Cerevis, 2 Bonfires, and 3 Magical Mid-Breaker Field, which I would play, but it's 3 URs that I'm not going to craft. During each player's main phase, one monster on the field cannot be destroyed by the opponent card effect. Also, neither player can target monster they control with card effect. So this is basically protection for your link one. It's a field spell. Then he's gonna run 3 copies, well, 2 copies of the Sky Striker Mecha Eagle Booster, which also protects your link one from being targeted. So if you want to run that thing, run it. The extra deck is kind of different, which is, again, I know about the Fairy Dragon, it's just I don't have the UR to craft it. And then, you, as you can see, he's also playing this one, which is a UR. It's a Lincoln Motion Art Genex, which you could make during your opponent's turn with the Tauren, which is really cool. And again, the rest of the extra deck, he got some Trishula, he has the Abyssal Dissipator, which I'm not running right now because of my deck is built different, right? So let me show you another one. Now, this is the deck that I use as reference from Ishmei Kizi right here, and it's 50 cards as well. He's running the Dark Ruler No More, which I don't play. And then after that, it's pretty much the same deck list. It's running 3 evenly matched. I'm only running 1 because I'm playing the 3 triple tactics talent, and he's only running 2 King Sarcophagus. So I just want to give you guys these deck lists right here as references, just in case you want to play them instead of the one that I'm playing, which these are really good and viable. So let's go back to my deck list. All right, familia. So again, this is the deck list. This is how I'm playing the deck. I got about 6 saucy replays for you guys, which I hope you enjoy. So let's get into those. All right, familia. So here we are for replay numero uno, number 1 of the day. And basically, I forgot to tell you during the beginning of the video, but one of the reasons why the deck is busted is because I deranked to Diamond 3, learning the deck a little bit, and then I climbed back up to Diamond 3 without really knowing how to play the deck. Like, I still kind of don't understand completely how to play the deck. I just normal summon until I can synchro summon, and then I figure it out from there. That's how I understand the deck. So here we're gonna start with the Crusher, normal summon it. They're gonna hit us with an Ash. And yeah, we don't care about that. We don't care about our first normal summon being negated by any means necessary, because we're going to just link it off. Now, if they have a gamma, then that's a different story. We stop the play right here. It's done. So we're going to link it off into the controller because I'm trying to control the situation as we get the Crusher back to the hand, activate the controller, normal summon the Crusher, which, mind you, none of these summons that we're about to do, except for certain ones, are special summon. So under Maxi, your opponent doesn't draw any cards, and you're going to see that as I took the Maxi challenge in the next replay. So here we're going to search out for our Turbo, normal summon the Turbo, activate the Turbo, get the planet to the hand because I'm planning to win this duel, normal summon it. Get ourselves the Birdman to the hand, hands rubbing together, normal summon the Magma, activate the Magma, get the Turing, and then we're going to normal summon the Turing. Now here, as you can see, we don't have any more space, we don't add cards to the hand, but that's fine, because that's why we search out the Birdman, right? So now here we have a level 2 tuner, which means we can synchro summon, and this thing becomes a level 3 if you use it to synchro summon to a Genex monster, which we're going to make our arms Genex return 0. Now we're going to activate the Birdman, bring a card back to the hand to special summon it. Now they would have drawn from this if it was Maxi, and now we get to basically do the whole combo all over again, start normal summoning. Normal summon the planner, get myself a copy of the Genex Undyne, activate the controller, normal summon the Undyne, activate its effect, and we're going to send to the graveyard the art Genex Undyne. And like I said, that's going to search us out the Genex controller so we can control the situation. Now we have a level 3 tuner and a bunch of bodies on the field, so you know what that means. We're going to synchro summon into the Doloner Tiger King of the Ice Barrier. Bring it out here. That thing, it looks tough. It should have an animation. And we get to bring two cards back to the hand. Now we get to basically do it all again. Normal summon the planner. Give myself another copy of the Birdman. Normal summon the Crusher. Activate the Crusher. Search out another Turbo. Now we get to normal summon again. Normal summon the level 3 tuner. Use all of these three monsters right here to go into Barong de la Flor. This deck is stupid. Activate the Undyne in the graveyard, target two monsters to add to the hand, and you add a card to the hand, you get to start normal summoning again. Normal summon the Turbo, activate the Turbo, get yourself a planet to the hand, activate the controller, normal summon the Genex Undyne, and this thing has an extra effect. You're gonna banish a card from the graveyard, and this thing becomes that monster's attribute, but also if you banish a tuner, this thing becomes a tuner and it's a level 4 monster. We could have made it level 10 here, but we don't want to. We're just gonna go and make an Animancipator Risen Dragite. This deck is stupid. Then we're gonna activate the Birdman, add the Crusher back to the hand. We get to normal summon a level 1, activate its effect, add the Birdman to the hand. Now we don't have any more space to basically normal summon after adding, but this is all we need because we have a level 3 tuner. Oh, before we activate that, we're gonna recycle some of our banished cards. Let's do that right now. Bring them back to the deck again. Level 3 tuner, level 1 monster, Herald of the Arc Light. Bring it out here. And that's your board, bro, after 30 years, because this combo takes forever. So yeah, infinite impermanence in the back. We can negate a bunch of different attributes based on what we have in the graveyard. Animation, put in recent Dragite, spell and trap negate. This thing, opening the gate and opening the gate. What are we really talking about? And Ash in the hand. What are we doing? What are we doing? Mind you, I don't really know how to play the deck. So here they're gonna activate the opening of the spirit gates. Well, by now I kind of know how to play it better, but we're gonna negate and pop this thing because we don't want to deal with that. He's gonna activate the Nightmare Pain. I'm gonna burrow on the floor that thing. Now mind you, it's gonna seem like I'm just activating effects here out of nowhere, but it was calculated. First of all, I don't want no opening of the spirit gates nowhere on the field because that's a bad, I don't want it. We have to negate and pop that. Now this thing, I should have waited until he activated his effect to pop, because I got angsty right here. This was a stupid thing for me to do. I should have waited for him to activate to pop a dark monster before I hit it with the Barong de la Flor, but we decided to do it early. It is what it is. Pop it and negate it. Mind you, bro is playing through almost everything. He's gonna normal summon the Sansara D-Lotus. We're gonna hit that thing with an Ash. Get it out of here. November mañana. He's gonna call it out, cross out Designator, get it out of here. I'm gonna Herald the Arc Light that thing because I need some light right now. But no, shut down the light with the Call by the Grave. Get it out of here. And yeah, bro opened up with an amazing hand because I even activated all of this not thinking, like, what are the odds that you have this? So now the Hero of the Art Light gets hit with the finger, cross out Designated, crosses out the Ash. D-Loaders get to go through and they're gonna special summon a Spirit of Yubel, but I have a infinite impermanence in the back row, so negate this thing infinitely. Stop that right there. November mañana. And that's, yeah, you're not gonna play through all of that. You're not gonna play through all of that, I'm sorry. Even though we could have negated this because we have a Dark Monster in the graveyard, but I didn't want to pop it because then the original Yubel would have came onto the field and that would have been another problem to deal with. So that's why we negated it with the Infinite Impermanence instead. We're going to activate the Dragonite. We're going to try and see if we could hit that Nibiru to bounce this thing back to the hand, which wouldn't matter because they could special summon it. Then we're going to normal summon the Crusher, getting ourselves the Turbo to the hand, and he's just going to scoop. It's pretty much GG's. There's nothing to do here, brother, anymore. You know what I mean? So, this deck is nuts, bro. The deck is nuts. If you don't get hit with any hand traps that actually matter, yeah, you're gonna probably win the game. So, let's continue. All right, familia. Here we are for replay numero dos, number two of the day. And here we're going against Katsura, if I'm not mistaken. Now, mind you, I don't remember if this is one of the replays where I didn't fully know what the heck I was doing yet. But it might be. Also, after this, I'm going to show you the Max C challenge in the Duelist Cup against Makenko. So here we're going to normal summon the Turbo. They're going to set up with the Max C. Unfortunately, it is what it is. Now, yeah, we could have done the combo. Again, you don't really care that much about Max C, right? So I ended up just searching out a monster. Since we have the Triple Tactics Thrust, I'm just going to set an Infinite Impermanence and Color of the Day. Because we have the Infinite Impermanence and the Nibiru. So, yeah, we might be okay. Now, mind you, we could have just normal summon a bunch of times, but I still would have gave him a few amount of cards, still doing the combo if I'm going to synchro summon into some shenanigans, right? So I decided to leave it like this. Here they're gonna special summon the Katsura Unicorn, activating the Theosis. He knows we have the Infinite Impermanence in the back, so he doesn't want to activate that yet. Luckily for him, he already has a Theosis in the hand. So he's gonna special summon the Fenrir, activate the Fenrir, getting himself the Katsura Rhysar, right? So he's going to activate the Katsura Rhysar, special summon it. He's going to go battle phase. He's going to activate this thing. Now, mind you, our extra deck is a little tight. I don't want him banishing the right things out of here. You know what I mean? So I decided to Infinite Impermanence this thing right here and now to prevent him from meddling with my extra deck. Because I don't need that right now. Don't want that. No. Nah, this is the worst match for us. So we're still going to get clapped up, get hit with the 1000 damage. Get slapped for the 1500 here. He's gonna use both of these, which I was praying that he would do the combo like this. Because now he goes into the Shangri, and he's really close to Nibiru territory. Activate the Rhysar, banish a card, banish three cards from my deck, which unfortunately is two of these, which is why we play three of them. We don't even mind this. Uh-oh. So this thing becomes a level 7. The Shangri is gonna target, lock down one of our zones in the monster zone. They're going to activate the Big Bang, detaching the Fenrir, so they can special summon the Fenrir. Then they're going to use the Katsura Rhysar to go into the Rhysar. And you know what time it is. Rock, Dwayne, the La Johnson, the People's Elbow. Clear the board, get it all out of here. I don't want to see none of that. Not today. So he's going to activate the Labyrinth Wall Shadow. He's going to send a Kessijin in the back, set down a back one end his turn. Which, I mean, it wasn't much. So we got the Horus here, and we have basically a bunch of one-card combos. And the good thing about the Horus package, in unison to this thing, is that you could send this into the graveyard with your Horus card, and now you're going to have a good day, right? So here we're going to search out the King Sarcophagus, activate the King Sarcophagus, special summon the Horus, normal summon the Power Planet, activate its effect, get myself the Birdman to the hand, and we're going to link off into the controller because I'm trying to take control of the situation, like I said. Normal summon the control, link summon the controller. He's gonna Forbidden Droplet here, sending this into the graveyard. He's gonna hit our controller with the Forbidden Droplet. Sad time with the Jesus Tears here. Negate that thing, November Mañana. And he's gonna scoop. Because we could legitimately get rid of the token, we could slap into him with our big body monsters, and essentially he doesn't even have any follow up. So yeah, he decided to leave. So let's go to the next crazy replay that I have for you today. Let's get into that. Alright, familia, here we are for replay numero tres, number three of the day. And I did play this deck a little bit in the Duelist Cup, and this match was insane. Oh, Duelist Cup music sound crazy. I didn't even hear this, but we're gonna start with the Magma Normal Summon. Almost all of these are one card combos. We're gonna link this thing off into the controller here. And we could speed this up a little bit. Controller activate. It's gonna hit with the Infinite Impermanence. And this is why we play the Sword of Ice. Because it's gonna protect us from this thing. Because if this thing gets Infinite Impermanence, Veiler, Ash, whatever it gets hit with, we're done with the combo. It's really frail. The deck is busted, but it's frail. He's gonna throw the Maxi, and we like challenges. We take those, activate the controller, normal summon the Crusher, get the Turbo. Normal summon the Magma, activate the Magma, get the Turbo into the hand. Normal summon the Turbo, activate the Turbo, get ourselves the Recycled. And you can see he's not drawing cards. Normal summon the Planner, because I'm planning to win. Get the Genex Undyne to the hand. Normal summon the Turing. And then we're going to use all of these to go into the arm of the Genex Return Hero. Now he's going to get a card off of this because this is technically a special summon. So plus one, activate the Berman. He's going to get a card off of this because it's a special summon. Now we get to normal summon the Magma. No more cards for him for now. Get the Crusher. Activate. Normal summon the Crusher. Add a card to the hand. Get the Turbo. Activate the controller. Normal summon the Genex Undyne. Send the Art Genex Undyne to the graveyard. Get the Genex controller. We have tuners over here, level 3, level 6 monsters, Dual Runner, Tiger King of the Ice Barrier. Now we get to bounce two cards back to the hand. He gets to draw one. Now we get to keep normal summoning. Normal summon the Turbo, get ourselves the Planner to the hand. Controller activate, normal summon the Planner. Planner gonna get ourselves another copy of the Birdman. We're gonna normal summon the Genex controller, which is a level 3 tuner with 3 of these monsters. We're gonna go into Baron de la Flor, bring it out here. Now we get to activate the Genex Undyne, target 2 cards, bring them back to the hand. After this, every card sent to the graveyard is going to be banished instead. So now we're going to basically normal summon the Turbo, activate its effect, get ourselves another Planner. We're going to activate the controller, normal summon the Undyne, which is going to become a tuner because we're going to banish a tuner. 2 level 4 monsters, Animes, Pitten, Risen, Dragite, bring it out here, that's mine. He's going to get to draw a card off of that. We're going to activate the Birdman, bring the Turbo back to the hand, and then we're going to normal summon the level 1, bring a card back to the hand. We don't have any more space. Level 1 monster, level 3 tuner, Hero of the Arc Lycos. It's a little dark in here right now after this challenge. But what are you going to do? Sit down the evenly matched in the back, activate this thing, recycle our banished cards. So yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We should have been like 50 cards based on how many times we summoned. But that's our board, and that's how we're taking the challenge. And we're playing against Makenko, so hit it with it. Get that thing out of here. There it goes, Lava Golem 1. But the crazy thing is that Lava Golem 2, yes. So our board gets wiped out, but one of the good things about the Hero of the Arc Light is that once it's sent to the graveyard by any means necessary, we get to search out our Sir Abyss. So that's kind of a good thing. Now our board is completely broken. There it goes. I don't even know what to tell you, bro. But here he's gonna activate the Makenko Reflection. Now mind you, I was wondering why the heck are you activating this here and now. So I started thinking to myself, and then he activated this, the double-edged sword, to put this thing right here. So I'm like, okay, you're trying to OTK, but all of these target, and you gave me the Sword of Viz by sending the Hero of the Arc to the graveyard. There's only one card that I care about, and there it is. So he's gonna activate the Makenko Water Arabesque, and that's the one that we care about targeting. That's the one that's gonna allow them to start comboing off. So this is when I'm going to activate the Sword of Viz. Mind you, this is my first game into the Duelist, by the way. So we're gonna negate that thing, and now he doesn't get to attach anything. And fortunately for us, he's gonna set Tobacco. He didn't even have any of his monsters. Out of all of those draws, it was just spells. And we could legitimately attack him with his own monsters and end the game right here and now. So it's GG's. That was a crazy one. That was a little crazy one right there. So with that being said, let's go to the next replay. Alright gang, here we are for replay numero 4, I believe it is. 5 maybe? No, it's 4. And we're going first against Asian Gears here. So we're gonna start off by normal summoning the Turbo. We're gonna get ourselves the Planner again, because we plan on taking this W. And we can speed this up. You basically end up on the same board if you, you know, depending on how you start off and how you do things. But essentially, it's not a linear deck. It's just depending on which one of your starters you open up with, you're gonna do different searches. But you're essentially also always gonna end up on something different. Now the way I think about it is, you're gonna get all of these monsters on the field, and you're basically just gonna get a tuner that allows you to make it level 10 while leaving one monster on the field for your Birdman. That's the easiest way I can remember it, because again, I don't know how to play the deck, I'm just an idiot. So here we're gonna make ourselves the Arms of the Genex Return. And like I said, as long as you leave one monster on the field and you have the Birdman, you get to continue comboing off like fresh. So again, normal summon the special summon the Birdman, normal summon the Planner, get ourselves the Undyne, activate the Undyne, send the Art Genex Undyne, get ourselves the controller to the hand, download the Tiger of the Ice Barrier, return 2 cards, normal summon again, get the Planner out here, get myself the Birdman. Again, we're gonna normal summon the Crusher, getting ourselves a 2-board to the hand. Activate normal summon the Genex controller, make it perform to the floor. Activate the Genex Undying in the graveyard. Return 2 cards back to the hand, bring them back into their mind. Activate the controller, special stuff with normal summon the turbo, getting ourselves another copy of the planner. Now we're gonna activate normal summon the Genex Undying. Banish a tuner so it becomes a tuner. And again, you could make a level 10 right here if you like. But we're gonna go for the Animancipated Recent Dragite. This is just the regular board that you're gonna go with this deck because it's the most efficient board. Again, bring the Burman out here. No more summon a level 1. Activate its effect. No more space. Hero of the Arc Light. Bring it out here. So then, again, yeah, this is the bread and butter combo that you're always gonna try and go with this specific deck the way I have it built, right? So we're gonna set down our 2 back row and end our turn. So here we're playing against another board breaking deck. They're gonna activate the Heavy Stone. We don't care about the back row that much, so it is what it is. We're not negating that. Normal summon the Ancient Gear statue, get it out of here. We're gonna leave that alone as they're gonna go into the Ancient Gear Golem. Now the reason why I didn't negate or stop the statue is because this deck kind of wants to send cards from the deck to the graveyard. So I mean, that's really good for us since we have the Herald. But also, I know what I want to negate, and it's this thing right here. And they don't have the spell in the back row that's going to prevent us from negating and, you know, interacting. So we're going to activate the Verundel of Flow to negate and pop this thing here. Because the Dark Golem is the most important card here. Let's negate that. Now he's going to activate the Triple Tactic Talent. He chose to draw 2 cards. We're going to negate that with the Animizer Credit Recent Dragite. Don't let him draw into anything. Because this is a board breaking deck. If they haven't broken your board yet, then they're desperate to search out board breakers. So negate that thing right there, negate it. Now he's gonna normal summon the Ancient Gear Waver. He's gonna search out the Ancient Gear Fortress, which is the problem. So he's gonna activate that thing's effect. I don't even care. This is the only thing that we have left to negate and pop that thing, and you have to do it, because if you don't negate and pop it now, you're not gonna negate and pop anything else. You're just gonna get smoked. So we're gonna hit the Hero of the Arc Light, negate and pop that thing right there. Then we're gonna activate the Genex Turing. I only activated this to show you that you can do this. So if you have another Genex monsters and buddies on the field, you could synchro summon right now. But again, negate and pop the fortress, activate the Hero of Arc Light, getting ourselves the Sword of Vist to the hand, and they're just gonna school. There's no more place for them to do. They already special summoned the statue. They already normal summoned a monster. They already special summoned the dark golem. They already used the it's GG's. Unfortunately for him, he didn't draw into any of the monster board breakers like Raigeki, Lightning Storm, and all the extra shenanigans. So let's continue.
Alright gang, here we are for replay numero 5, I believe it is. Number 5 of the day. We're going second against Ice Barrier, if I'm not mistaken. Here they're gonna normal summon the Revealer, send a card to the graveyard. We're gonna ash that. Because they say it's a really good card to ash, but again, they have the Call by the Grave on them. Give the Ice the finger, get it out of here. Nos vemos mañana. Dow them digits, she's gone. She is gone. So from here, they had to proceed and doing. He actually did a pretty good combo here. Normal summon the Mirror Mage, activate the Mirror Mage, send the Revealer to the graveyard. He's gonna get his tokens right here. And now he's gonna use the Mirror Mage and their tokens to go into the Coral Dragon. Bring it out here. Now he gets to activate the Mirror Mage. He's gonna search out the winds over the Ice Barrier. Activating the Georgius to special summon it, activate the Georgius effect, special summon the Revealer back onto the field, level 4 monster, level 6 tuner, Lancia of the Ancestral Dragon of the Ice Barrier. Now he gets to activate the Coral Dragon, draw a card, activate the Winds basically tribute 2 tokens to special summon the Spellbreaker and to special summon the Speaker of the Ice Barrier, set down a back for end their turn. Now, let me see something real quick. It's not 2 level 4 monsters. Yeah, why didn't he special summon the other one instead of this? The one that the one that basically I have to give up cards in order to activate monster effect. That would have been a better one to summon, but that is how he made his board, right? So here again we have the Maxi, which is doesn't do anything. I'm gonna activate the Amsterdam since we can't activate spells because of the spell breaker on the field. I'm just gonna get rid of the Lightning Storm and deal with the back row later. That's just how we're gonna do it. So here we're gonna join 2 Infinite Impermanence, activate the Infinite Impermanence. We're gonna negate the Lancia, normal summon the Turbo, which is a 1 card combo. It's gonna get hit with the Infinite Impermanence, clap it up. Cause you have played yourself. We don't even care. We don't even care. That is the perfect thing that could have happened right there. As we link up into the Genex controller so I can now really control the situation. Because we dealt with a few things. Get myself the turbo back to the hand. You don't have any monster in the case. Normal summon the turbo. Activate the turbo. Get the planet so I can start planning on how I'm going to take this W. Throw out the Maxi. What? What is he doing? What's wrong with you, bro? That thing is prompting too much. I need my time. That's how much you don't care about. This deck is busted that you could just throw out the max C so you could not waste time with the prompting, because I get tired of it. It's just that simple. I know we're going to win. So normal summon the planner, activate the planner, get myself the Birdman, hands rubbing together. We're going to normal summon the level 2 tuner, activate the Birdman, bring this thing back to the hand. Normal summon the planner, activate the planner, get myself another Birdman. As you can see, this is one of those dudes where I didn't really know what the heck I was doing, but you don't need to. As long as you just know what you're going to synchro summon into and you could get those bodies on the field to do so, then just do that. If you don't know how to play the deck, you'll eventually figure it out. So we're gonna go into the Briar Mac here, the Magical Ice Dragon. We're gonna activate its effect. We're gonna get rid of a card to send the genius back to the graveyard so we could activate cards in the graveyard ourselves, because we're gonna send the Undying, if I'm not mistaken. So Birdman, bring back the planner, activate the planner, normal summon the planner, search out the planner, get myself the Genex Undying, yes sir. Now we get to normal summon the Genex Undying, send our Genex Undying to the graveyard, getting ourselves the Genex Controller. Then we're gonna use both of these monsters to go into the Dual Loner target of the Ice Barrier, bring it out here. We have to bounce two cards back to the hand, bring them back out here. And yeah, as you can see again, I didn't know what the heck I was doing because I completely forget. Once you activate this thing's effect of itself to special summon, like if you normal summon it with the controller, then it'll just go to the graveyard. But if you special summon it off of its own effect, next time it leaves the field, it'll get banished. So you just saw me banish my own card like an idiot. It's that simple. So here we're gonna search out the magma. It's not that big of a deal because we get to continue normal summoning, activate the magma, getting myself the crusher to the hand. We're gonna normal summon a level 3 tuner, use all of these monsters to go into the arms of the Genex Return Zero. Think it would have been better to go into Burundel of Floor here, but it is what it is. Well, no, never mind, because I have the Undying in the graveyard. This was the best play. So now we're gonna get ourselves our turning back to the hand and the Undying back to the hand, which basically are essentially two tuners. We're gonna normal summon the crusher, activate the crusher, get the turbo, and then we're gonna normal summon the tuning. That way we could use all three of these monsters to go into our Burundel of Floor now. So I'm basically using way more resources than I should to do the combo, because again, at this point in time, I really didn't know what I was doing. We're gonna pop the Lancia, get it out of here. I'm gonna activate the arms of Genex, whatever, and it's GG's. We basically dismantled the whole board, which wasn't a crazy board, but we got through. We don't even care about you negating spells. We barely play any spells. We only play spells in the Horus package, which is insane. So with that being said, yeah, let's go to the next replay.
Yes, sir. Here we are for the last replay of the day. Replay numero 6, number 6, if I'm not mistaken. And we're going first against the Math Mech people. Now we're going to normal summon the Magma. We got stops. At some point in time, I didn't actually get to make the board here. We're going to link off into the controller. We could speed this one up. And Infinite Impermanence. Again, once you get hit with Infinite Impermanence or Veiler on this thing, your combo is done. There's nothing for you to do. The deck is busted. It's pretty insane, but it's more frail than a freaking wet noodle, bro. So yeah, stop that right there. But no, because we negated it with the service. Normal summon the crusher, get the turbo. Normal summon the turbo, activate, get ourselves the planner. Normal summon the planner, we're not planning anything because the people's elbow, the rock, Dwayne Dilla Johnson. Get it out of here. That's also another hand trap that will destroy us. We're gonna activate the triple tactic thrust here, getting ourselves the triple tactic talent. Activate the talent, and we're gonna look at his hand. And by looking at his hand, there's no point in sending this back, right? We don't care about sending that back. This is the best thing that we could get out of here, because if he gets to link summon it to anything, this thing is the craziest combo extender. And then they have the got Chidi Ignister right here, which we don't care about because I don't even think he can normal summon it. So really good on us for looking at the hand. We're gonna set the Infinite Impermanence, which is all we have, but we have the insight on what they have. Now we know what the heck they drew into. It's a Sigma, of course it is. Activate the Ignister card to special summon it, and now from here on it's full combo. As they go into the Splash Mage, start splashing. Here they're gonna activate the Ignister again, targeting the Splash Mage. Splash Mage, special summon the Sigma. Sigma, link off into a Link Decoder Da Vinci. Bring it out here. Of course, now he's gonna use the Nibiru and the Splash Mage to go into the Transcode Talker. He's gonna try and talk to me about his strategy. We don't care about that. We don't care about that. As he activates that thing's effect, we're gonna Infinite Impermanence right here and now. Right here and now, stop that right there. Which is the best time to Infinite Impermanence, because that makes it awkward. He can't OTK from here. He just can't. So let's see what he does. He's gonna go into the G Golem Crystal Heart. Bring that thing out here. This thing gets to activate its effect to special summon the Transcode Talker. Bring it back over here. Piercing damage.
pierce the token, get it out of here. Slap me for the 3,400. Slap me for the 500. Leaving us with 3,000 on the dot life points. So here we're gonna draw, and we know what this is, bro. You know what I'm saying? We know this is a super pectorial. We looked at your hand. It was the only trap or any stuntable card that you have. We have the one combo card from here. Mind you, I got to link up into the controller. You don't know this because I never got to finish the combo. I also didn't really know what the heck I was doing here. I was just going to figure it out as I go with the flow and do my synchro summoning and shenanigans. Now I know more how to play the deck. But I'm telling you, I went 14-6 with this deck. And a lot of those games, I didn't really know what the heck I was doing. I just want to be honest with you, bro. Now I know what the heck I'm doing, but it was hilarious that this deck is so busted that an idiot like me can play it without really knowing what the heck I was doing. Even though I have a pretty good grasp of a lot of cards in the game, so that's probably why I managed to win. But yeah, let's continue. Alright, familia, so those are the replays. That is the video. This deck is busted. I don't know what to tell you. Now, mind you, is this deck worth building? I think it is. The only downside, again, if you're gonna build it, make sure you have a lot of protection for this thing. Because once this thing resolved, it's pretty much an auto win. It honestly is. You're gonna end up with such an amazing board that unless they have lava golems, board breakers and stuff like that, you're probably gonna have a good time. Now, mind you, again, you probably will lose a good amount of times if this thing gets negated and stop pop. Gamma is your worst enemy. Gamma is the worst trap that can happen to this deck right here. It really is, because even if you negate it with the Ash, as soon as you activate any one of your normal summonings, they still can activate the Gamma. So unless you could completely negate and destroy the Gamma, you're probably gonna lose to that. I'm gonna keep it a buck. Now again, I'm sorry that I took so long during the intro. I just wanted to give you guys different deck lists, so that way you could play the deck however you want, you know, in different ways. This is the way that I was playing it. I like it. I enjoyed it. Now, I probably wouldn't really play this deck all that much. I'd rather play like a Centurion variant, because Centurion is more fun than this. Spending 30 years normal summoning is not my cup of tea. It's just really not. But either way, again, I hope you guys enjoyed the content. If you did, please remember to leave a like, share, comment, and subscribe to the boy, because I would greatly appreciate it. Enough with the yapping. Any comment, questions, or concerns in the comment section below, I try to always reply. Continue having a great day, and I'm going to catch you guys next time. Peace!